there. My name's Willow.
In our last episode, we learned about motion and forces, like pushes and pulls. Today, I'm going to help the Quinks discover that the bigger the force applied to an object, the bigger the change in how fast the object moves.
Thanks, Flux. I almost forgot. And we'll find out what happened to poor Quasar at the end of the last episode. I hope he's okay. Are you ready? Then let's get quinkin'.
Quasar!
Quinks.
Neutrino!
Quinks.
Flux!
Quinks.
This looks promising. Now that's moving fast. Ah, straight at me!
What happened?
Well, this guy threw one of those big ball thingies, and this other guy hit it with a big club, and it came flying straight at me.
Sounds like a baseball game. Baseball's so fun.
Yeah, if you call almost getting hit by a big, gigantic ball thingy fun.
That part, not so much. But baseball can be a great way to learn something about motion. Tell us the whole story.
I can do better than that. Bubble Pop?
Watch. The ball is moving in one direction. Then the force of the bat changes its direction.
Bubble Pop, could we skip this part? You mind?
See if you can change the direction of an object in motion.
So a force can change the direction of an object that is already in motion. Mega amazing!
Let's go see.
Wait up, Flux!
Hey, I'm supposed to be the leader. They're doing everything with their feet. What's up with that?
Maybe their hands are tired.
Let's observe the different ways force can change the motion of an object. How did the ball's motion change?
I'm not sure.
Let's look again. How did the ball's motion change?
I got this. The ball was staying in one place. Then the force of the player's foot put the ball in motion.
Willow showed us that, remember?
Totally true! How did the ball's motion change?
Beats me.
Let's look again. How did the ball's motion change?
It started going a different way?
Totally true! The force of the player's kick changed the ball's direction.
like what happened at that baseball game. Ugh.
How did the ball's motion change?
Let's look again.
How did the ball's motion change?
It stopped?
Right. The player's foot applied a force that stopped the ball's forward motion.
Totally true.
Motion is so fun.
Forces can put an object in motion, change the direction of an object already in motion, or stop an object's motion. See how many ways you can change the motion of an object.
And we know everything there is to know about how forces can change the motion of an object.
Are you sure? Quinks, what will happen when I push the ball with the stick?
You'll put it in motion?
Exactly.
Ooh!
Now, what will happen if I push the ball again, but with more force? What do you think?
Right! We Quinks think that hitting the ball with more force will make the ball go faster.
That's a good guess, Quasar, but I want to know for sure.
I know! We'll create an experiment!
What's an experiment?
An experiment is a careful test to see whether something is true or not. Can you think of an experiment to test whether pushing a ball harder will make it go faster? I'm going to hit some balls. One a little harder than the others.
So if we guessed right, the one you hit harder will go faster.
Right, Nishina.
First, we mark a starting line and a finish line. Now, all we need is a way to measure how long it takes each ball to travel between the two lines.
No problem. Bubble pod.
Neat. Are you ready, Quinks?
Ready.
Ready.
And are you ready to help us measure the time it takes each ball to go from the starting line to the finish line? Here goes the red ball. Here goes the blue ball. And here goes the green ball.
Now, let's put the times in order from fastest to slowest.
I'm coming.
This is so exciting!
Why don't you try putting them in order, too?
I observed the time very carefully. And the green ball was fastest. The red ball was in between. And the blue ball was slowest.
I'm coming.
I have that too. Same here.
Now, the moment of truth. I used the most force on the green ball and in between amount of force on the red ball and the least amount of force on the blue ball.
We were right! The harder Willow pushed the ball, the faster it moved!
That's true in general. The bigger the force applied to an object, the bigger the change in how fast the object moves.
Motion is pretty amazing! Kinda like me!
And there are people who use the power of motion to do ultra-amazing things.
Let's go see!
Wait up, Fox!
Next time, I am so going first!
Hi, I'm Todd.
We're Quinks. We're from outer space.
We're here to learn all about your planet. What we're exploring now are motion and forces.
Then check this out. I build robots that move in all kinds of ways. And the more I know about motion and how to use pushes and pulls, the more fun things I can make my robots do.
I'm here.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready to go. I am going to the chair. Okay, how did I do?
You did great.
Even I'm impressed.
When I grow up, I want to be just like you.
Okay, then see if you can figure this out. Use these things to build a machine that will push a ping pong ball with enough force to make it fly into a cup.
We'll totally try. Bye, Todd.
Thanks from outer space.
Can you think like an engineer and figure it out?
The different ways forces can change the motion of an object.
Looks like our work here is done.
Except for singing the song.
we're explorers.
Explorers.
The world, that's what we explore. We're explorers.
Explorers.
Day after day, learning more and more.
How did I do?
You did great.
Gotta go, Willow! Thanks for everything!
Willow, you're the best!
I know.
We'll be back.
And I hope you'll be back to help the Quinks make more discoveries.
Till then, let's all be explorers and see what we can discover about this beautiful blue planet of ours. Are you ready? Then let's get quinkin'.
Quinks.
Quasar.
Quinks.
Neutrino.
Quinks.
Let's.
Quinks.
Quinks.